All right, everybody, welcome to another episode of The Urban Gardener. I want to thank you all so much for joining me here today. If you haven't already, please hit the subscribe button down below. Follow along with more garden adventures as we continue growing here on The Urban Gardener. Today, I'm out in Southern California. We're here in LA. I'm visiting A Million Drops, which is a youth outreach center here in the downtown area. And we're here to visit Charles Malky of IV Organics. He volunteers his time here at this outreach center to help them out with their urban organic garden. So let's get around and check out this garden, and we'll talk with Charles here in just a moment.
So the first thing I want to share with you here in the edible garden is this 4-in-1 apple tree that was gifted to us by Steve Liss at the Sylmar Agricultural Center. And a quick something about them is the students at the Sylmar Agricultural Center grow upon about an acre of land, a whole bunch of cuttings and seedlings that then go to benefit the entire surrounding community all the way throughout pretty much all of Los Angeles and maybe even outside of Los Angeles. They donate so much good out of their property. I just want to give a quick thumbs up and shout out to the Sylmar Agricultural Center. If you take a look at the apple tree, you can see it's fruiting. Here it is, November. It's even flowering over here. But again, it's just a little confused. I think by the time we took it from there to this area where it maybe just got more sun, it's thinking it's spring, whereas again, here we are in November. I expect all these leaves and all the fruits to fall, and hopefully it's gonna come back with a lot of energy, and we still gotta find a home for it. It's still in the container. We're gonna find a place for it in the upcoming weeks. As we come down over here, you can see that we've planted some lettuce. We got some basil back there. You can see some red tomatoes. We've got some other younger tomato plants that were installed, which we've gotta stake up and bring up. Those will be some more future lessons I'll be teaching here in regards to creating double and triple vine tomatoes instead of growing them in the bush method, and there's a lot of benefits to doing that. As we go through, you can see there's some Swiss chard. In this area over here, we planted a whole bunch of onion bulbs. We got a pack of them for about $3, and it probably included about 200 bulbs, and we were just planting a whole bunch of onion bulbs throughout the property as well. This will go into improving flavors of meats and salads and a whole bunch of stuff as well. And then we've got over here some purple cabbage, some more Swiss chard, another tomato, some rosemary. And these are all newly planted. We're still working on this. Another gift that we have over here is some dragon fruit. There's about 6 or 7 of them, again, donated by the Sylmar Agricultural Center. We're gonna be finding homes and basically creating hedges. As you can see, as you wrap around the property, you'll notice that there's a whole bunch of fences surrounding the property. The goal is to cover the entire fence with an edible hedge, which will include dragon fruit and passion fruit, and even our vine tomatoes, which we're gonna be installing by springtime. So as we continue, I mentioned the passion fruits. If you take a look down here, this was one of our projects about a month ago. I brought some passion fruits from my home garden, if you've seen them on the Ivory Organics YouTube channel, and we basically created per container. Let me find one of the better ones over here. We've basically created 3 cuttings. For those of you that have seen my cutting methods, we usually cut the leaves in half, and you can see that there's now some new growth that's coming out. All of these leaves were also whitewashed. We used the Ivory Organics 3-in-1 plant guard to basically organically cool the plants, again, serving as an anti-transparent, keep helping the plant retain more moisture, and now you can see they're all resulting in more growth. Pretty much every one of these, this one here has 2 cuttings, and both of them are growing. There's new growth on both of these ends. And when it comes to whitewashing, one other thing I want to share with you. When using whitewash, the traditional method, and I would say 90 to 95% of the people that whitewash their trees are using chemical paint. If you put paint on your house, 100 years later, there's still paint on your house, but if you put paint on your plants, within a year or two, all that paint's gonna end up in your soil and it's gonna stay there forever. So that's, again, another reason that the Ivory Organics products were born, to offer consumers an organic, healthier alternative for accomplishing all the benefits of whitewashing in a healthier, much better way. So here's the passion fruit plants, and if we come over here, you can see that there's also this flower garden, and some of the volunteers with A Million Drops are planting a lot of flowers. You can see over here they use these rain gutter structures to basically plant a whole bunch of stuff from California poppies. Over here we have alyssum, which is another great beneficial flowering plant to have in your garden, as it attracts these beneficial wasps that'll eat a lot of aphids and other small pests within your garden. So this is an easy way of planting something that's both beautiful and beneficial to the organic garden. So, but let me share with you a couple of the fruit trees that we also now have in the garden. Follow me. So I just got this email literally within the last 30 minutes from one of the distributors, Central Garden, and they write, "Hi Charles, I'm at a sales meeting and we're looking for products to protect against freeze." And this guy, Pete, writes, "Someone mentioned your product, but I read info and saw no frost protection. Do you have any frost protection products?" And the way it works is the Ivory Organics 3-in-1, this product over here, which is protection against damaging sunburn. That sunburn protection is offering protection, and here I'm standing next to a Haas avocado that we installed here at A Million Drops about 3 weeks ago. And you can see, and we did a YouTube demonstration showing how we planted it. It once had a tree that was about 15 feet tall and dead, hibiscus, that we then uprooted and planted this Haas avocado that's doing now quite well. We've whitewashed the entire structure with a foliar Ivory Organic spray. When you come in a little closer, you might see the whiteness on the leaves, as well as the entire tree trunk. Here are the leaves. And then the tree trunk, we then brushed on with the can formula by simply filling it up with water. We had the brush on solution to basically protect the tree trunk. So in the summer, when we have the extremes of heat, we're basically reflecting that excess heat and protecting the underlying plant tissues, specifically that cambium tissue that underlies the bark of the tree. In the winter, it's also insulating the plant, basically curbing the extremes of those nighttime low freezes. So it's offering that protection as well. And that's pretty much the predominant benefit of whitewashing your plants. The Ivory Organics blue label specifically has the words whitewash on there with protection from summer sunburn and winter sun scald. So when you see the blue label Ivory Organics, you'll see exactly that. And I just want to just share with you how proud I am about this Haas avocado again that we planted only 3 weeks ago that has since pushed out a good 4 to 6 inches of new growth. You can see all of the buds underlying here are pushing out some new growth. And it's really happy in this location. You can see that we've mulched all around it.
All right, everybody, we're here at A Million Drops, and I just happened to just drop in today here unexpectedly on our friend Charles Malky of Ivy Organics YouTube channel. And we're here to visit A Million Drops, a nonprofit organization here helping out.
A Million Drops is focused on helping those that are homeless as well as at-risk youth. Specifically, they're aligned with organizations that allow the homeless and at-risk youth to come to a place where they can take a shower. There's educational resources available. There's also food that's made available to them every single day of the week that they come here. And there's organizations that all contribute to make sure that those in this surrounding area, and we're specifically here at the Hollywood Adventist Church, and A Million Drops is headquartered here on this property, and they've invited me just a few months ago to help oversee the vegetable garden and to bring some more fruit trees and nutrition to the organization. So that's what we're here to do.
This is a really excellent little project. You took me around for a little tour, which we've shown everybody here on the channel. You got some really neat little things going on for an urban garden, you know, which is what we specialize here on the Urban Gardener, urban gardening. What was it that brought you here to this organization to volunteer and give your time to help them build this really nice garden?
So someone obviously in my community knows my passion, has been watching the Ivory Organics YouTube channel and says, hey, I think your skills, your resources could be of value here. I came down. I was a little concerned, I must admit, in regards to, you know, what am I going up against? You know, I love volunteering, I love contributing, and I do that everywhere I go. But I've never done anything one-on-one with the homeless of LA. It just seems to be something that's, you just can't make a difference. It's everywhere. I mean, you'll see homeless underneath bridges, along freeways. It just seems to be something that even, you know, the city of Los Angeles can't keep up with. And we just keep on hearing about all these problems. But ever since I came out, literally within the first minute, within the first few minutes, I knew I could make a difference. And with the people within the organization, they already know this. But for those of you that are hopefully watching this, get involved. There's a lot of great people. There's really the only difference between a homeless individual and ourselves is that we have a shelter and we're working, you know, the homeless people are working hard too. But this world's just getting harder and harder to live in. And at the end of the day, the goal is just to give them an edge, give them support, let them know that they're loved, let them know that they're cared for. As they're people just as you and I are, they're just exactly. trying to make it, you know, on a day-to-day basis and try to plan for a better future. So
you never know what your future is, you know. You
never
know. Exactly. And that's where a lot of people are in the position right now. And I can definitely tell you got a real passion for helping people and doing this sort of thing. And it really kind of, you know, you can tell when you're here and you see the different things that you're working on and putting together and the different people that are here that you're communicating with.
Yeah.
You know, they're all waiting over there to come in and check out the garden and work and do different things and see what's going on there. And it's just really, really something inspiring to see. So I encourage anybody else out there, if you've got an opportunity, get out and volunteer, help out and do something in a community like this. Get out there and do that. And especially if you've got some knowledge and skills like Charles has to bring to this organization, give it to them, volunteer it, put it out there and get it done. Now I want to ask you, Charles, though, let's get into gardening just a little bit here.
But before we do,
okay,
I just want to share one more thing. With 8 million drops, they're really a safety net again for the homeless okay. and the at-risk youth. I'm gonna, or hopefully you will, add to the Urban Garden a link with the 8 million drop link where viewers, if they're able to contribute, please contribute. And again, it serves as a safety net. It provides resources and guidance and leadership to basically help. And a lot of the people that are within the homeless organization have found jobs. Even those that are working and employed can't still afford rent. Like, it's really hard. And if for those of you in the Los Angeles area, you understand that rents are high, the cost of living is high, and it's happening more and more across the country. So the people within the community need to offer a lending hand to kind of bridge these gaps and to let them know that they're cared for and not simply abandoned, you know, off the side of a freeway. So, but that's what we're doing. But now let's talk excellent. About gardening.
Excellent, excellent caveat, Charles. Yeah. Really, really important point to make there. Absolutely. And definitely links right down below to anything that we're talking about here. Million Drops, Charles' YouTube channel. We'll have all of that right down below for you. And if you can, please go and contribute. Now,
awesome.
Let's talk about gardening now.
Let's talk about gardening.
How and when did you really get started? What really was the thing that brought your mind to, I'm going to dedicate myself to gardening and developing what you've ultimately developed into a business?
Well, that's a twofold question. I mean, the gardening and the passion existed since I was born. My earliest memories was spending time in the garden with my mom, who I feel inherited her green thumb from her father. And she just basically spends as many hours as she can within her work schedule caring for the family, also caring for the garden. And I saw that passion at a very young age, I'd say 5 years of age. And I remember specifically she'd plant the tomatoes and the squash and whatever she had in her garden. And I would look at it and rearrange it and put it like in what I thought was a better design. But the passion just continuously grew through high school, college, and until today. Like, it just continuously grows.
So and one of the things I remember you talked about earlier, you did take a little divergence from gardening in a sense in your life. You
Correct.
Went to college to in law, right?
I did. So the twofold question is, one, the passion started at a young age, but my path was originally pre-med. So I got my degree in biology. I published in National Journals of Medicine on some concepts that are integrated into the Ivory Organics formulas. So that was like 20 years ago. And then I ended up thinking, okay, if I'm not doing medicine, there was no other alternative other than for me going to business school. I was thinking I want to do business. My family somehow convinced me to go into law. So I finished law school, and when it came to finishing the bar, I didn't pass the California bar, but passed in Florida. So I ended up practicing law there, specifically foreclosure defense and real estate law for 8 years. Owned my own title company, owned my own real estate brokerage. And once my daughter turned two, I didn't want to raise her in a place without family. So we made a financial decision to leave the successful law firm of 10 years and start all over.
What a risk.
Yeah. Right? So in 2012, we came back to LA, which is our home, and basically started developing the Ivory Organics concept. And here we are today.
Excellent. Excellent. Yeah. So let's take a moment and talk about Ivy Organics. You
Yes.
have a nice product line here that you were talking about with me a little bit earlier. Let's go over it with our audience here and talk about the different things that you have available.
That'll be great. The first and foremost, and the first product that was ever created before all of the colors were also created, is this here, the Ivy Organics 3-in-1 Plant Guard. It offers protection against damaging summer sunburn as well as winter sunscald, insects, and rodents. And the product comes in a, it's got an organic dry base powder as well as an oil vial. And the oil vials include 7 natural garden oils, which include castor, cinnamon, clove, garlic, peppermint, rosemary, and spearmint. And when you basically add the organic base with the oils and mix it up, you can brush it onto your plant. This one can also make up to 5 gallons of the ready-to-use spray, which is this product over here. So this little pint makes 5 gallons of something you can spray on the entire plant. And the benefit of whitewashing the entire plant lightly is that it'll help, one, as an anti-transpirant, helping the plant retain more moisture, which is important at the time of transplanting. So if you're ever repotting a plant or you're planting anything in ground, a lot of consumers have got a lot of benefit from just seeing a lot less transplant shock by spraying the entire plant structure. And the entire concepts behind these products is a gardening concept known as whitewashing. Even though the word whitewashing isn't on this label, there's also an Ivy Organics blue label product which simply says whitewash on there for summer sunburn and winter sunscald without the added benefits of insect and rodent protection. But the whole Ivy Organics concept with this line of products is simply whitewashing, which is pretty much insulating the plant from the extremes of summer and winter.
Excellent. All right, now, so you've got the Ivy Organics formula. How did you develop this formula?
So some of the brains that went behind the concept of the Ivy Organics 3-in-1 Plant Guard goes back again to my biology years at the University of California, Irvine. Whereas working on testing out this antibiotic, it was encapsulated. It's called the lipid encapsulated antibiotic. And lipid is simply a fat encapsulating the antibiotic. And it was used at the site of surgery within people. The idea was by inserting these antibiotics that were encapsulated with fats, is that it would last longer at the site of surgery, breaking down and offering protection far longer than if you were to take antibiotics orally, where you've got to take your medicine 3 times a day. But by putting an encapsulated antibiotic at the site of surgery, it would last, they've noticed, days and up to weeks.
Right.
Similarly, the goal within this product is the base ingredients, which include iron oxide, limestone, mica, these milk proteins, silica, and these methyl cellulose, which are all sticky. The goal is when you brush it onto, for example, the tree trunk and lower branches that are exposed to too much sun, with these added oils, the oils are encapsulated within the product and offering layers of defense. And so when you add, for example, a second coat, you've got now layer upon layer of castor oil, cinnamon, cloves, garlic, peppermint, rosemary, and spearmint that otherwise in the natural state would only last a matter of hours, maybe a few days. But encapsulated, you're offering defenses that can last a month or several months to up to a year, depending on your weather conditions. So, but that's kind of the concepts that, you know, underlie the Ivy Organics 3-in-1 Plant Guard.
Really, really, really amazing concept. Yeah. I like the idea of how you develop that from that to come up with that. That's just a really, really amazing thing.
No, I'm glad you asked.
I really can't wait to try that. You do have another one here called Six Macros Plus.
Yeah.
Could you explain the six macros?
Absolutely. So I'm more and more excited about this product the more and more I share it. But the Six Macros Plus fertilizer, it was developed because we could not find a fertilizer on the market that offers the plants all of the macronutrients. And when you learn about plant health and what are the nutrients plants need, all of your research will say plants need six macronutrients. But then you go and you look at your fertilizer bag and it's like,
just NPK.
You see NPK and maybe sulfur and maybe calcium and maybe magnesium, but it's like, why won't you put all six macronutrients into one bag of fertilizer? And another important one also was azomite as well. Yeah. And the value, like a lot of those micronutrients will offer. So we've got two different sources of volcanic rock dust that have also been integrated that are also highly, you know, I don't say highly soluble because they'll still settle, but you can suspend it and then apply it to your plants as well. So
and
this
then
is
distribute from there.
And then distribute it from there. So yep. This product here, the Six Macros Plus Fertilizer, this is a premium blend and a super blend. The super blend has the highest NPK with percentages that are closer to about 12 and 13. Also very soluble. And then this one over here has an NPK that's a little lower with a 2-4-4 and then 1-2-17. And those percentages are the percentage of the macronutrients you'll find within the product. This one here, again, the premium blend is got nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, magnesium, sulfur, and calcium. Those are your six macronutrients. The micronutrients include iron, manganese, zinc, copper, and boron. And then it's also improved with beneficial microbes or mycorrhizae. So when you add it to your plants, it'll improve the whole soil biology as well.
Everything.
It's got everything. Like, so that was the goal. And then this little bag can make up to 20 gallons of liquid fertilizer. So one of the best applications I want to share is this here 11.8 ounce bag. You can take one tablespoon to a gallon of water and really integrate it into your entire planting method.
Just making a compost drip, tea out of it.
Put it into your drip system if you filter it to make sure it doesn't clog any of your lines. You can even use it as a foliar nutritional spray to get all of that into your plants. A good way to take care of your plants during the winter when you're not fertilizing and still getting nutrients in your plant.
A real versatile product there. Just a lot of
six
different values
plus
to it. That's really nice, really nice.
Yeah.
So like I said, we'll have links down below for stuff there.
Cool.
But how do people get hold of your product?
Great question. Obviously, one of the easiest ways is Google, I guess. You can find a lot of retailers. There's about 100 retailers from East Coast to West Coast that offer our products for sale. The nurseries, if you're going to your store and they don't have it, we also are aligned with the number one and number two biggest distributors in the country that stock our products. And those two gardens distributors would be Central Garden as well as L&L Supply. So if you go to your garden center and let them know that Central Garden and L&L Supply, so you can basically contact them and they will make the products available to your nursery and they can see the entire catalog price sheets for that as well. So there's a lot of ways you can get your hands on our products.
Excellent, excellent. So it really kind of gets us to the idea of what you're, I found you through YouTube, and you have a really cool YouTube channel, whereas you do feature your products, but you also get into showing people gardening, and you have a real lot of gardening knowledge out there. So
That's
kind of one of the things I like to talk about. What, besides your products, really led you to the idea of getting out to the YouTube platform and getting out in touch with all the YouTube gardeners out there?
Great question. So what attracted us and brought us to YouTube was, honestly, the fact that we needed a launch pad for marketing our first three commercials. Ivory Organics invested on making three quality commercials, and we needed to place them somewhere. So We landed on YouTube in October of 2015. And then it wasn't until, I would say sometime spring, March or April, that I said, I got to teach how our products work. And I had an opportunity to then show step by step how the Ivory Organics products can be used in the home garden. And it's with that we actually got our first YouTube subscriber about 3 to 6 months later. We had no YouTube subscribers with the launching of the commercials and linking those into the websites and stuff. But it wasn't until I started teaching that we got our first YouTube subscriber about 6 months later.
Excellent, excellent. And so how long ago was it when you started?
So that was October 2015. Here we are now, November 2018. So 3 years And a month later, from the time we landed on YouTube, and I'm proud to share that we're now, you know, in excess of 40,000 YouTube subscribers. Today, November 13th, we've just exceeded 4 million views on our YouTube channel. And I can say with confidence that we're now a leading garden product YouTube channel, ahead of pretty much all the other garden products you'll see on your garden shelf. We're in first place. And again, it wouldn't have happened without people like you and the viewers. And I appreciate the fact that you've taken so much value at the content. We've so far shared about 200 educational lessons. But it wasn't for you guys liking it and sharing it and seeing that it was of value, we would have never made it.
That's one of the things I really, really like. One of the things that, you know, my audience has heard from me plenty of times is I love the garden community. I love the social media community when it comes to gardening. I'm a real big fan of a lot of different YouTube gardeners out there. And I really like seeing people apply themselves and put themselves out there on the YouTube format. Myself, I just passed 1,000 subscribers.
I wanted to say congratulations.
And I'm thinking that's really, really big time.
It is.
And here I'm sitting with somebody who's got 40,000 subscribers.
No, but that first 1,000.
I got really something to look forward to.
First 1,000 is the hardest, and you'll see that it's just going to keep on getting better and easier and more enjoyable as you keep going.
It really is. And it's really fun when you get to sit down and talk to people like yourself, Charles. You've got a great passion for what you
awesome.
Do. It shows in everything that you're doing here. And when you're discussing and talking about your product, you can tell that you're really, really in tune with what's going on out there. And I really, really appreciate you coming by here on my channel and sharing with us. Not only a million drops here in this really great urban garden, but your products and your passion for YouTube and gardening.
That's awesome.
I want to thank you so much for joining us today on this episode. And if you can, please hit the subscribe button down below and follow along with more garden adventures. And if you have any questions, comments, concerns, or anything at all, hit us up in the comment section down below. And give this video a big, big thumbs up for Charles joining us here on The Urban Gardener. And we'll see you again on the next episode. All right, man.
Awesome.
And it's brought me here, just...
all right, let's see. All
right, here we go. It's an outreach center here, a learning center for it's a learning center for at-risk youth here in Los Angeles, California. Classes and learning gardening skills. Let's get out, let's go. I am stumbling so bad. All right.
I'm so tired.
All right, we'll see what happens. All right, everybody. Oh, the helicopter.